Hey everyone, this is Cypher going back my playthrough of Persona Q. Today we are going to fight the Merciful Clergyman. But first we have to figure out who our destined partner is. If you want to see the Merciful Clergyman fight, the timestamp to it is in the description as usual.
Hold on, please.
Okay, holding on. Well, yeah, the Guardian. It's what we came here to fight. Do this. Gotta open this door. Gotta find out who my destined partner is. Final question time. If you haven't found a partner yet, or haven't, like, selected a partner question, a correct answer to a question, correct in quotation marks, technically correct. Anyways, if you haven't selected that now, this final question basically does it for you. Makes you choose.
You have at last reached the final room.
Okay.
The final question with sweaty palms.
So sweaty. Okay.
Yes, it's time to review your choices thus far.
Sounds like a good idea. Does age, sex matter? It does. Good time is inside. That handwritten poetry was what she dropped. That was a really awkward question. Gotta get in that lion cage, man. I can't swim. The gigantic one is better. Apologize. Sorry. My heart, because you can't do any of the others, and screaming roller coasters, because duh, yeah.
And so, laugh, or cry. Here comes the last question.
So, okay.
You can answer it, if you wish, or elect to not answer it.
I think I'll answer it.
Your specialty dish is?
Curry, meat and potatoes, pickled mackerel, meat and potatoes.
Are you absolutely sure?
Good choice.
You have summoned your will and selected an answer.
I did.
Concludes the questioning. There are no correct answers, only the path you have chosen.
Oh man.
The time has come to announce your destined partner.
Finally, huh?
Yeah, Olin, you would be looking forward to this.
Carefree, since this doesn't involve them.
Quiet. Don't let your guard down.
Yeah, we gotta figure out who my destined partner is. It's totally going to be amongst this group. Maybe it's Chie. Maybe it's Mitsuru. Maybe it's Koromaru. Maybe it's... Oh wait, it's Marie.
I'll tell you just one thing. A heart-melting spell. A kiss is a kind of magic. Whatever you know,
the sleeping beauty. Why are you next to me?
I don't know.
I can't believe you're eavesdropping.
I can't believe you're here. Whee! God bless this game, I love it. That was quite the fall.
What was that about? Makes no sense. Butt hurts. It's the lame worst.
I'm pretty sure lame worst is not a word, but we'll carry on.
So, why am I here with you?
I don't know.
I was in that blue room.
Yes, you were.
I'm
not sure myself. Panic!
Why are we holding hands? Yikes, no way!
Yeah, way.
It seems you have reached your destination.
What?
This seems to be a lover posture. Lovers who met their destined partners discuss their love for each other. What could be waiting up ahead?
I'm not sure, mechanical voice.
Step forth, hand in hand. Curiosity and fear in your hearts, or you can refrain.
Distinct? Lovers? I mean, lovers?
Yeah.
Wait, what are you saying?
Exactly what you heard.
You are free to step forth, or refrain from doing so. These are your apparent options.
Like, yeah.
Now, step forth.
And the mechanical voice is fallen silent. He doesn't talk back. We established this.
Why are you all quiet? You're the one who called me here, right?
I'd love to. I'm fine without his, though.
What? I'm not.
You're not.
You've got a totally diseased mind. Stupid pervert sleazebag.
Your motor mouth's running again. You were summoned here because reasons of plot nature.
If I
Oh, that's what I like to hear, though.
We're supposed to walk on, right? I guess we should go.
I am such a sucker for brunettes. It is not funny.
Suddenly, all in attendance hear an announcement.
Oh, boy. He's in the back.
Up ahead, they see a bride and groom's joyous commemorative photograph of love.
Dude, sounds like a good time.
Between them, whether to look at it or ignore it.
This is gonna be good for our walk.
A photograph of love? Ugh, lame.
If you say so, Marie, you're gonna love it though. I mean, you're stuck to me anyway, so come on. I know. Isn't it as great? Oh, wait.
This isn't real. This is just a fake coated with lies, and, stop looking at it!
I can't help it. It's in front of me. Oh, my God. It's such an obviously edited photo, though.
What the hell? Why are you and me?
The answers I have selected have chosen this, Marie. I'm not sure, but maybe I should pick you up and find out.
Huh? Hey, what are you doing? Put me down!
She's embarrassed.
Stupid moron pervert! You're the worst! The worst of the worst!
I love you too.
If you don't put me down, I'll hate you forever!
Oh, I can't refuse that.
You're seriously unbelievable. Like the patron saint of perverts.
Yeah? The other answer selections actually, like, give you, like, one-liners. Pick her up is the only one that gets her on a rant.
People hold hands, wear dresses, and dance this waltz thing, right? They posed like you just did, too.
Cool.
Why are we going to a dance?
Ooh, Dad, I don't know. Sounds good to me.
Ball. Dancing a waltz, huh?
Sounds great. Okay. Let's go.
Let's hurry up and go. The ball ends at midnight, right?
I'll take that as a yes to our date. Moving forward. And backwards a little bit.
My hand's getting tired. It's hot, and I can't let go. This is the worst.
Don't you think?
Walk is fun, though.
I'm glad that you enjoy that. Oh. Yeah, you should step with us in the labyrinth more often. Hey. I don't know what you do, though.
You and I are like the moon and the stars.
Really?
We're close, yet far. But we can't be separated. Tragic distance.
Yeah. She found her inner peace just there. Jouetami? Jouetami. Oh, yeah, it's French.
You've got it all wrong.
Jutam. Ah, even I get it wrong.
You got that? Nuances are important.
Gotcha.
Forget it. This conversation's over.
I love these gestures that they only make in this scene. I love the handcrafted love that happened in this scene. All the characters get it too. It's just beautiful.
The long-awaited moment has come. The bride and groom are finally about to enter.
Yeah, to the ball.
Has arrived. Before you are to be wed.
Oh, that's not what I was thinking. I think she missed it.
Through your own free will, you decide to vow eternal love to each other.
Well, that's one way to crash a date.
This makes any sense at all.
Oh, at least Marie isn't catching on.
I mean, are we doing the waltz here? In glass slippers?
That'd be fun, actually.
Now, open the door, together.
I mean, like we have a choice.
Hey, but I don't have any glass slippers.
Oh, don't worry about it. Oh. Oh, thanks for spying on us, Rize.
Time out! Time out!
Depending on who your partners are, like, if you pick Yukiko, like, Chie gets super mad at you here. But otherwise, she's just like, time out, time out. No, but it's the fun concept that count. Sounds great.
No,
wait.
Don't come near
me. Rei seems terrified of this priest. Clergyman. Oh, by the way, meet the merciful clergyman.
He must be the guardian of this place.
This is quite the unique boss. Okay, he's gonna start off with a move that magic finds, and ain't no one got time to deal with that, so... I'm gonna just go ahead and do that and set up some stuff. I could set up the Shinkoha... I could use a Shinkoha. I'd probably just go for a Shinkoha here, try to do some damage. I could set up the firewall, but it doesn't do anything. I'm gonna make it look easy. Okay, Yosuke doesn't really set up anything either. I could try to go for a Chintarafu, but I don't think it will work. But I mean, trying Chintarafu is probably better than doing nothing on this turn. He's weak to- oh right, the boss is weak to lightning. Derp, 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 derp. Yeah, just go for a Chintarafu, even if it doesn't work. Because I'm gonna probably set up the Lethargy Circle. Yeah, I'm gonna set up the Lethargy Circle, so I wanna do that now. I could do either the Moderate Kaja to buff myself, or Bestial Roar to just buff him. Because I'm going to be using Zanaga, I probably just need to use Bestial Roar to buff him and not the other way. Yes, Holy Blessing. There we go, and we're going to be using Lethargy Circle. Let's get this show on the road. Holy Blessing is up. See if Tantarafu lands. It didn't.
Seriously?
That's okay. Circle miss, that's okay. I'm surprised that missed and didn't trigger the Holy Blessing. I really thought that was just gonna trigger the Blessing. Bow to me that you won't strike. That means you can't use your physical attack against him. Your skills are totally on limit, so you can just use them. So I can use Shinkoha for more damage, or I can just keep spamming Zanaga. I'm probably going to use Shinkoha this turn and just, like, alternate between the two. I can try Chintarafu again, or I can just use a different skill and try doing some damage. Especially since I'm going to start using Toxic Slice now. So I can probably just get away with launching Aglaia or Garla at him. Probably should be fine. I just used Bestial Roar, so I want to use either Fang Smash or Kidney Smash this turn. Or I could set up the Madara Kaja. Yeah, we'll set up Madara Kaja, that's fine. You can set up a Mind Charge. Oh god, was I really just about to use Mind Charge without trying to set it up first? Oops, don't do that. And then we're going to use Toxic Slice. Yes. Madara Kaja is up. Red Rider is going to use Shinkoha. He's going to take a nifty 200 damage. With an additional 97. Hit for weakness for 184. And let's see if we can land the poison. Yep, got it. I love how the coffins don't get poisoned, that's a really cool detail. Larger circle is continuing to miss. Alright, get in there, man. Okay, so we successfully avoided the first bow. I'm gonna take 310 poison damage. Alright, man. Alright, we can do whatever we want on this turn, which is fine. I'm just going to spam the same moves I used last time. I might want to consider holding off on Yosuke's SP, especially since I can just attack him and that'll be fine. Yosuke has a infusion weapon, so if that lands over the poison, I'm fine with it. I set up Madara Kaja, so I should definitely go for a Kidney or a Tempest, Kidney or a Fang Smash this turn. Go with Kidney. It's more likely that an elemental attack will screw me up than a physical one, because the front three characters have armor that resists physical moves. I'm going to set up the Mind Charge on this turn, and I'm going to, I guess, extend the circle, right? And the circle still has two turns left. I can just Megado his face, right? She doesn't use much SP otherwise, so it's okay for me to do so. Queen Mab's access to Mind Charge is very crucial for this fight if you're lower level as well. I'm a little over-leveled for this fight, but if you're lower level, I definitely just recommend getting a Queen Mab. She's gonna help you out. That hurt. Okay, this is one of the worst ones. I do have a Holy Blessing up, so I can get away with breaking the vow, but don't do this at home. I'm assuming it stays up. See if my Holy Blessing stays up. I'll take your word for it, man.
Did he say vow not to use skills?
Yeah. Attack, attack. I guess you attack too. Attack! Okay, well, I can't set it up. But that, I don't want to float the Mind Charge either, do I? Okay, I don't have enough SP. I can't, wait. Okay, this lasts three turns. Okay, so I can get away with not using it this turn. Scared me half to death there, game. Toxic Slice wore off too, so we're doing less damage over time. Doing nothing but normal attacks on this turn is probably crappy. I should probably defend with some people, but I'm not worried about it. Maybe he gets confused. Nope. Maybe he gets silenced. Nope. Heart Slash. Missed me. Didn't land the Lethargy Circle. That wore off. Vestral War fell off. I believe Madarakaja is still up. Yeah, Madarakaja's still up. Alright, I'm just gonna blitz him down. I really am in no danger. Thanks, Mash. Thanks, Mash is fairly strong, even if he's not bound. Go for the Mind Charge Xayanaga and go for a Meg. I don't have enough SP for Megado. Guess we just set up Lethargy Circle or go for a Toxic Slice. Toxic Slice! Seems good. Reminder, I only curb stomp this boss because I'm stupid overleveled. He's probably gonna die this turn, with how much stuff I'm throwing at him. Plus 310 damage poison, plus the Mind Charge Xayanaga that's landing on his face right now. It's... Oh lord. That's pretty bad. I don't think it's gonna live enough, long enough for that to matter. Multiple vows. So I can't use items, and I can't attack, or I can't defend, and I can't attack. I don't remember which one the green one is. Yellow one is skills. Didn't die to the poison damage. See? I have no idea who Agape is. I do not play enough Persona to know. Okay, so he didn't ban skills. He's banning items and attacking. Yeah, that's what he's doing, so... I guess we go for an Arrow Rain. Yeah, it's fine. Sash him in the face again. Sash him in the face again. Magic Bound sucks so much. I think he's just gonna die to the next attack. Like, he had to trigger his cutscene, and for him to trigger his cutscene, he had to have health. I don't know. I'm pretty sure he just dies to the next bit of damage he takes. Yep. And that's the Merciful Clergyman. You're not supposed to be level 31 for this fight, you're supposed to be, like, level 25. 24. And I want to run a Galileo. I want this. I want Fatal End. I probably don't need Firewall, but it might be good to have. I don't know. This gives me more options because I don't have Fire yet. I literally have every element but Fire on this dude. Between this dude and me, so I guess I get rid of Firewall. So many good skills. Either get rid of Firewall or get rid of Fatal End, and I love dang it. I guess Fatal End is the most useless of them. I'll get rid of Firewall. I might regret that later. Swordbreaker coming up, nice. Bestial Roar, such a good skill, forget it. And we got the Torn Bible. Go for it, then.
No!
Why are you so afraid of it, Ray? A ring.
Don't touch that!
What's going on? Are you okay, Ray?
Sorry. I'm sorry, Zen.
It's all right. I'm as confused as you are.
Is that a toy ring? Like the ones they sell at fairs? I had one back in the day. It made me feel like a princess, and that was my royal heirloom.
So, Zen, is anything coming back for you yet?
Actually made sense with Yukiko's character, because she's always wanted to escape from her day-to-day life.
Yes, I was searching for something in this world. It was because Ray cried, but I couldn't find it. Ray, I think this ring is yours.
I don't know.
You don't know?
Then why did you tell me not to touch it?
I don't know. I just thought that you shouldn't.
That stuffed rabbit we found in the previous labyrinth, that was also Ray's. Why are her things in the depths of the labyrinths?
Zen... I hate you, Zen!
That's not true, Ray.
Hate.
It's all your fault! I don't care about you anymore!
Something tells me Ray's getting some memories back.
Ray, don't cry. I'm sorry, it's my fault.
Are we kind of intruding here?
This cruelty is trying on us single people. I do have a space open right here, you know.
Good job, Teddy. It's very smooth. Aw, oh, shut down. Even here.
Well done, everyone. When you get back, please come to the Velvet Room. Another lock is about to come off.
It is. Then our hypothesis was correct.
Yeah, next time we get to do spooky things. We shouldn't meet... This episode shouldn't last that much longer. So let's just trail backwards. Very straight line, no room, so you just walk around. You can't step off into behind the pews, but I guess it's fine. And you go backwards, just in case you didn't see some of the scenery around here. They have, like, a swing set, a spinning heart that says, Happy Wedding on it. Man, Marie really did not pick up on these hints. Got a painting. Speaking of Marie, where the hell did she go? She isn't an experienced traveler. Doubt she has a go-home with her. She's too busy writing poems all the time. I believe this one also says Happy Wedding on it. Yep. And then you have an exit, and that's it.
That wall's bugging me.
Yep.
It's weirding me out.
Stairs down, and we have this. And that's your way back there if you ever need to go back there again. I've already opened the chest. It has an item that lets you sometimes do something with some sort of whatever. It doesn't matter. Just go home out of here. Yes, do remember to bring your... Oh, I guess I could have just gone back for the teleporter. But it doesn't matter, ultimately, does it? Shame Marie wasn't there to witness that. Wow, it looks a lot prettier without all these locks all across it. Now it only has, like, three.
As soon as that bell rang earlier, the locks started rattling.
There seems guardians and take what they are protecting, these doors will open.
Seems good.
It's clear that these doors are connected to the real world from which you all hail. We looked into them, and we don't sense the presence of shadows beyond these doors.
Seems good.
From one of the doors, I detect the familiar air of the world I know well. And from the other, Elizabeth and Theo say they feel something similar.
Okay, so one's the gateway to P4, the other one's the gateway to P3. Gotcha.
Two left. That means we're halfway through.
Yeah, only halfway through, Asterix.
I get through this sooner than we expected.
Only halfway.
Huh. I wouldn't have figured you to be so spineless. Well, at least there seems to be no reason to rush this. We'll be fine if we stay properly prepared.
Oh, heard.
Fukuchan and I scouted out the next labyrinth.
Seems good. Is it spooky? Confirm spooky.
Second year class 4? I thought each year at Yasogami High only went up to class 3.
Well, it used to go up to class 4, but what do you know of the school's history?
Yeah, it's weird. Evil Spirit Club? Oh, that name's already a huge red flag for me.
What, you're scared? What happened to those kung fu skills?
She is not very good with... I mean, she watches movies. Shinjiro, that's it. Sure.
Well then, everyone, please be careful on your way.
Unless we're playing Pokemon. Alright, I love this game. So hey everyone, this has been Larvik as always, and thank you for watching. Next time we'll enter into the High School Spirit Club. See you guys then, bye-bye.